أعزائي الطلاب، السلام عليكم. أخذنا في المحاضرة الماضية اللي هي introduction about اللي هو الديكودر. And decoder from the name decoding, we are decoding information. The information, any type of information, analog or should be converted to digital or to binary code, and this binary code can be represented using or decoded using the whole decoder. If we have n bits of information, we can represent them with 2 to the power n bits using a decoder, and this is will give a big ability to represent the real or more reality or more precise type of information. For example, look at your screen resolution. The more bits, the more numbers the resolution is, the more precise picture you get. So, and this is the decoder. We can convert, for example, 3 input bits to 2 to the power 3, which is 8 different combinations, 8 different combinations, which will represent these 3 bits. So this will give us a very precise representation of the input, okay? Very precise. The more digits we have here, the more precise or the more reality we get from decoding, okay? And we go through the implementation gate of the record of the decoder, and we said we can use the AND gates to generate the output of the combinations of the input. Okay, if we have 3 inputs starting from X, Y, Z, then we can have 2 to the power 3, 8 outputs. One of them only can be active at the same time. Okay, active, we mean if we represent with using AND gates here, one will be active and 0 will be deactive. Okay, so we will have only one output active or only one. So you can see that the output of the decoding is many terms. This is X not, Y not, Z not. X not and Y not and Z not. Okay. And D1 will be mini term X not, Y not, Z not. This is mini term 0, mini term 1. Why D0, D is we use D0, D1, D2? Because this we are talking about digits, and this decoder, as an example, will convert the binary code into a octal number. For example, if the output is 3 zeros, this will give us, will activate D0, which is the 0 octal number for 3 zeros, and so, okay? If we have 3 ones, 1, 1, 1, this will activate the D7, which is the number 7 in octal, representation of the 3 bit variables X, Y, Z. So here, the idea here, we are using AND gates, okay? So the combinations are many terms. So this will give us an example. We can go back and represent, use decoder to represent all of the functions that we took before in chapter 3. We can use decoder because we are getting many terms from the decoder, and ORing this, the value ones of the functions, we will get the decoder representation for the function, okay? So any function can be الايديا هنا انه اي فانكشن نقدر نعمل له ريبريزنتيشن باستخدام الديكودر عن طريق انه اورينج كل الفاليوز الوانز تبعت الفانكشن اوكي اللي هم الاوتبوت تبع الديكودر. And we talked about the multiplexers. The multiplexers is a decoder, but we have enabled bit, okay? So the enabled bit will make the decoder works. So the enable bit is not it's not considered here as an input. Enable bit, if it's, for example, 1, this means with the inverting to 0, this means it will 0. So it will be 0s to all, 0 to OR in NAND gates, generating all these ones, okay? So 0 الones here representing inactive state for the output. For example, here 1 1 1 1 1, no, none is active because we are using NAND gate. Okay, so the active field decoder, we can represent the active using NAND gate with 1, and the active في NAND gate as in this slide we can use it with 0. So this nothing is active because the enable is 1. So this after that is 0 after inverting the E. So we are not enabling the work of the decoder. So we are getting all these 1 1 1, nothing is active. Okay, XX, so we don't care what A is B or B values, all will be 1, so the decoder is not working. Okay, okay, if the enable, if we want to enable this decoder, we input enable bit to be 0, which will be 1 here. The one will be ended with all these, and it will, we can get the results from this decoder. This decoder have 2 inputs, A will be, so we will have 2 to the power 2, we will have 4 inputs, D0, D1, D2, D3, okay? The first one, 0, 0, 0, 1, when we have all of them zeros, which one is active? Okay, in the previous implementation, it was the one active here, because we are using NAND. لاحظ البابل هنا after the AND, we are using NAND. So it's active if it has a 0 value. So D0 is active. Here, when we input 0, 0, 1, the active is D1. Because we are using NAND gate in this decoder. So if the input is 0, 1, 0, then the active will be D2. If we enter 1, 1, and the enable is 0, then all these will be deactivated. So we don't use this, all of them will be 0. So not none of them will be active. So in a matter of fact, if you will be asked, إذا حد سألك, what's, when this decoder is working, the first thing, this decoder is implementation using NAND gates, so active will be 0. It works only when the E, the enable value is 0, and only works in this situation, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. So it gives one active state. But for 1, 1, we are having non-active, none of these will be active, none of the whole output will be active. So this is the decoder. The idea here is enabling the decoder with a bit, enabled or not enabled. For example, if we input 1, it will be disabled. If we input 0, it will be enabled, okay? So the decoder with an enable input E, we call it demultiplexer, okay? This is the first idea. The second idea here is that we can implement using AND, like we can implement the decoder using AND, like in the previous example, and generating many terms, or we can make the decoder or design the decoder with logical gates NAND. So in this, what's the difference? The difference here, the active will be 0. For the AND gate, the active state for D will be 1, okay? So whatever you do, whatever implementation you do, we can have this general implementation or general design for the decoder. So whatever inside AND gate or NAND gate, we will get 2 inputs multiplied by 4 outputs. So we have 2 inputs and we have 2 to the power 2, which is 4 outputs. And with enabled E bit, okay? So E here will be built, so inverted here with this bubble. So this will be enabled by a 0. If you enter 0, then it will become 1, then it will be enabled. If you input, for example, 1, it will not be enabled because the invert with the bubble will be 0, so it will not give any output, okay? So the multiplexer, who is decoder with enabled bit, okay? This is, you can implement it in another way. So don't look inside. Inside it can be AND gates or it can be NAND gates, okay? So here, the same thing, demultiplexer, it's a decoder, the same thing. But here we are talking about the enable bit. So if we have one enable bit, then for two inputs or for two select here are they called demultiplexer, then we will get four outputs, okay? Bit, four outputs, bits or combinations. If we have two enabled, so what we get? Demultiplexer. So if we have two enables, then we can generate more outputs or combinations of output. Look at this expansion. For example, we have here only three inputs, yes? So this will generate 2^3, 8 outputs, okay? And we have, it's enabled here with W. W is the enable bit, It can be zero. When it's zero, then it will be inverted to one. This will be active. So we will get the first 8 bits. If we give here one, so the one will go to this decoder and activate this decoder, which is taking the same X, Y, Z as input, and the output is 8 bits. So what's the idea here? The idea here is by controlling the input or the value of the enabling bit W, we can get, in the matter of fact, 4 to 16 decoder. So it's the same decoder 3, 8, but if you control the W by 0 and 1, you can get two decoders. You can expand two decoders to be 4 to 16 decoders. Okay. So we have here 4 to 16 decoders using the implementation or the design of only 3/8 decoder. So 3/8 decoder by using an enable one time 0 and another time 1, we get two decoders that will produce for us 4 to 16 decoders. Okay. So here we can, it's like, the W here is will control which decoder will be activated. So this one will be activated, or this one will be, or this one should be activated, dependent on the value of the W. The idea here that you can build from 3/8 decoder by adding expanded to the same decoders 3/8 with an enabling bit, which you provide, switch it to 1, you will get 8, and switching to 0, you will get another 8. So we will have by result 4 to 16 decoder. Okay, a question here, how can we get 5 to 32 decoders? Well, of course, you can just provide another enabling bit, and another, you add another 3 in 8 decoder, or 2, 3 in 8 decoders. So you can get, for example, for two enable variables, 3 input variables, you can get 32 decoder output combinations. Okay, so you can join them and control them using enabling bit, as we see here. Okay, if you remember, we said that the decoder, if we have 3 inputs, we will have 8 outputs, the decoder. And one state will be active for the decoder. But if you want to represent a function, you can ORing them. You can just, okay, this is, we OR miniterm 1 and miniterm 2 and miniterm 4. If you OR them, then you get S. This is a function. So ORing these miniterms out of the decoder, we can represent any function we want. For example, in this slide, we want to go back to our full adder, and we want to design it using a decoder. So how can we use that? How can we do that? Designing the full adder باستخدام اللي هو الديكودر. Okay, I have اللي هو three input variables here, x, y, z, and I have here اللي هم الميني تيرمز اللي هم from 0 to 7. Okay, if you go back to the equation for the sum, it will take the value 1 for mini term 1 and 2 and 4 and 7. Okay, we go to the decoder, mini term 1, mini term 2, mini term 4, and mini term 7. All of them, if we OR them, then we get the sum or the S, اللي هو value, the sum of the full adder. What about the carry? If we go back to the truth table of the carry, the sum and the carry, we have the carry will be 1 in the mini terms, 3 and 5 and 6 and 7. So we use this decoder and we OR the mini term 3 and mini term 5 and mini term 6 and mini term 7. We OR them using the OR gate to get the carry. So in this slide, we use the decoder to design our full adder that we talked about before. In the matter of fact, we can use this decoder to represent any type of function. All what you need to do, you will go to the decoder and find the many terms that represent the value 1 for the function, and you make them input to OR gate, then you get the function. And in this slide, we are representing the full adder by representing the S, اللي هم الميني تيرمز 1, 2, 4, 7, 1, 2, 4, 7, and الكاري اللي هو 3, 5, 6, 7, 3, 5, 6, 7, to OR gate, sum to OR gate. So we are getting here, we have a decoder, and we have a full adder presentation, okay, representation. So this is one of the applications of the decoder. So you can implement using the decoder any type of function, okay? Simply because in the decoder, we have the input, we have the mini terms. So the mini terms are the values that we have to do on the OR gate, we have to do the function that we have to design, okay? So this is how the combination logic implementation using the decoder to represent any type of functions. And an example is the full adder, okay? Okay, we have two possible approaches using the decoder. Or, for example, اللي هو many terms of F, إذا تذكر, we can use اللي هو ORing. أو ممكن نستخدم اللي هو NOR, many terms of F, اللي هو 2 to the power N minus K inputs, okay? In general, it's not a practical implementation, okay? So we stick to the first one, by ORing all the many terms of function, we can get any key inputs, for any key inputs, we can use decoder and OR gates to represent this function, okay? Okay, this is for the decoder and how to implement it using AND or NAND gates, and how to use the decoder to represent any function, and an example of using the decoder 3 to 8 to represent اللي هو الفول ادر اللي اخذناه في المحاضرات السابقه. Next class will be اللي هو الانكودر, how to implement الانكودر. Of course, الانكودر هو عمليه ريفرسنج, يعني بدنا نعمل ريفرسنج from اللي هو الـ output 2 to the power n to the n. So the encoder هو عملية reversing the decoder, which we will talk about next class. That's for now. Thank you for your attention and see you next time, inshallah.